anybody else from my ticket. Praise God. Hallelujah. It doesn't work that way. But because there is a passion in my heart, there is a conviction in my heart, there is a hunger in my heart to know my Heavenly Father on a greater level than I've ever known Him in all my life before. There is a hunger to know Him, a hunger to see His face, a hunger to demonstrate His covenant through my life. You know what that is? That's my ticket to first class. I don't even know if there is a coach. I hadn't thought about that much. I'll leave that one for your pastors to grapple with. Oh, it's great to blow in, blow up, and blow out. Send me the tapes, will you guys? I wonder if there's a coach. You got me thinking now, Bergdorf. Is there a coach section? Praise God. Tim, put up the track, Father Me.
If
believe it is registered that you are operating in areas of preference that you need to make a more firm commitment to, I want you to raise your hand right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, 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 yes. Comfort levels, to move beyond.
Thank you. give up is your preference. And it is my conviction and my trust that for those of you who obey God and were in your place today, that God has released an anointing of His presence upon your life to place such a conviction in you that it makes no difference what anybody else does. You know God put you here. You're connected. You're committed. And we're going on. We're going on. Gary and I had to come to a place in 1989 and 1990 when God called us to take praise into the streets. That was such a radical concept. Before anybody had ever heard of Graham Kendrick. It was before there was a march for Jesus around the world. And I don't mind telling you, the thought was frightening. Sometimes I could not believe that we were actually putting out mail telling people we were going to do this wild, radical thing. And there was the concern that nobody would come. And we had to settle in our hearts that if nobody came, God told me to take praise to the streets, and I was going to do it. If I was by myself, I was going to do it. It was a conviction. And we have to have the same kind of conviction about the mission that God has given us as a church body. We have a mission. We've been raised up by the Holy Spirit to a purpose. And there has to be that kind of commitment and that kind of conviction that if nobody else goes, I'm going. I'm going on. If nobody else wants to worship God, I'm going to worship God. If nobody else wants to offer salvation to the lost, I'm going to offer salvation to the lost. If nobody else wants to stand up for justice and righteousness, I'll take it in the face that
He came up here and he shared glory with us today, folks. I mean, I got convicted to my toenails.
That's good, too.
I mean, he just took... Are we even going to look for that remote control at the house? It got lost a couple of days ago. I don't know if Whitney took it and hid it or what happened, but it's gone.
Of God into her midst. Speak a word of hope and encouragement and comfort and to bring the anointing of God. And the Lord spoke this passage of scripture into my heart last night as I was drifting off to sleep. And I've had it in my heart for God to send Brother Jim back to us for several months. And have prayed and sought God about it, about the right time. And the Lord put this in my heart and he spoke to me. I sent him to you for this time and for this season. For some of you, as God is my witness, the word that you received this morning, had you not received it, you would have been forever pulled off course of the divine destiny of God. God, this was a divine appointment. This was divinely sent of God to speak a word to us and to bring the power and the glory and the anointing necessary to bring about that wonderful spiritual adjustment that so many of us need at times in our heart. And some of you have desperate financial needs. And the enemy has used fear and intimidation to cause you to close your purse. And you've ceased sowing, some of you. And leastways, if you haven't ceased sowing, you've backed way off over where you were, say, a few weeks or a few months ago and what God was speaking to you. And it was because of fear. The enemy came to steal for the word's sake, came to steal God's blessing from you. And the Lord, in his love and in his mercy, is providing for you an opportunity just like he provided for the widow to sow a seed into the soil of the servant of God. And if you'll do it in faith and with conviction and release your faith when you plant that seed, God's going to do a miracle for you. I just speak a curse against every demonic force of doubt. Let's just not give place to that. Let's just resist that. Oh, don't the devil be such a liar. I reject doubt. I reject that. I choose the word and faith in God. And now I'm going to follow my conviction. And in response to the word of the Lord, which I see before me, I'm going to sow my seed. I'm going to sow it in faith and believe God for supernatural provision. I want you to ask the Holy Spirit what he wants you to do in the blessing of the word.
Okay, well, you got a green light down here.
That's right, that should take us on.
Okay.
Appreciate your kingdom, world. retract. Then he has his foot in the door to do everything else. If he cannot first distract the focus of my heart off of that personal, intimate relationship with my Heavenly Father and onto circumstances or anything else, then he can't do anything else. He can't. See, the 91st Psalm guarantees that. But the 91st Psalm is the benefits of the 91st Psalm are reserved for individuals who are not in any form distracted. I talk with hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people. I've talked with, I don't know, thousands of people, I guess, that, your part's a little crooked here, I've talked with thousands of people that are, to one extent or another, in the midst somewhere, consumed with some form of difficulty. It may be major or crisis. Maybe major or maybe minor. It may be family, marital, financial, difficulty with children. They may be suicidal. They may, a variety of things. You know, they may own a major corporation and it's on the rocks. A variety of situations. And without exception, I have found the one common, the panacea, the cure-all. Okay, I have found, if we put it in capsule form, it would be the most widely prescribed. I heard a guy use that terminology the other day. I have found an answer. It's like one size fits all. The common answer that I can give everybody, whatever their problem, whatever their situation, I always find out that, first of all, the root of their difficulty is that somewhere they have gotten distracted. Every single time. The first...
My name is Vinny. I'd do anything for Vinny.
We did. That's too bad, ain't it? I mean, he can't take a joke. He can dish it out, you know, but he can't take it.
Sometimes to reach it, don't
he? Yeah, he learned not to try to jump in my back turn. Honey, Vinny wants some. He wants some grape.
This thing is sweet.
Look at that dirt. Look at the dirt.
When I fell on my face?
No, when you're making fun of that guy playing the guitar, do it.
What?
You're doing this.
Oh, Jerry Clamper.
Take me, Gary. Take me.
I love it. Right on her hair.
That's not fair.
Now, how do you grow these, didn't you?
He did the ground, I grew them.
He did the what?
He tilled the ground, I grew them.
Oh, I see. What'd you do, Dale?
You
want to
sing it, buddy?
You
worked for it, don't you?
Oh, it's gone, isn't it?
Sorry. Oh, I'm forever on tape now.
You've got a seat on your
Jessica, and there